Hai everybody. So, ini satu pertanyaan dari Bapak Imran di Makassar. Saya dengar bahwa teori EB itu harus 40 jam seminggu, yang artinya ya 8 jam sehari. Jadi kira-kira betul atau tidak, dan bagaimana tentang itu ya pendapat Miss Wira. I heard that a theory about ABA that have to be like 40 hours a week, which is like 8, means like 8 hours a day. So, is that true? What do you think about this?
See, earlier what they have done is while doing the studies, they did 40 hours with the children, and they found that children were really improved so well that there was very little comparison between a neurotypical child and our children. Okay, that means the children improved so well, and you could not say they had autism because they did so much intensive therapy there. But now what happens in the States and everywhere, insurance covers also minimum 20 hours or 40 hours of therapy. That's why all the agencies, they insist on 40 hours. But in the Asian countries, it's not possible to give 40 hours for some of them because it's not covered by insurance. What I want to tell you all is, intensive therapy, if you can give, give. If not 40 hours, try to give minimum 10 hours, 15 hours, and you will see the results coming up. Mm-hmm. Got it? Mm-hmm. It's not exactly that 40 hours, if you are not able to afford, what can you do? You can still give intensive therapy, but maybe start from 10 to 20 hours, and then check whether the mother can also get trained, and she can give some more hours. Is that okay?
Yeah. So actually, I was just curious, like 40 hours a week is a lot of time.
See, 40 hours a week is fantastic. 40 hours doesn't mean that the child has to sit on a therapy program 40 hours. It can be even in a school setup where he is always on a behavioral objective, and he is also going, he's got a learning support teacher, though not intensive, but he is following the behavioral objectives while eating, while doing. So there is a kind of interaction with the child, and he's not left alone. Okay. So intensive, maybe 10 hours, not so intensive in the net, maybe 10 hours, and you can still practice ABA, yeah?
Yeah, so it's like the solutions for us, like we don't really, I mean, like in Asian country, don't cover by insurance, so it's going to be very expensive, like what cover for
yes.
hours.
See, whatever you can afford, do do that, and still you'll get results. But what you might not get is, suppose I'm doing weekly three times or 3 hours, that may not be so important for one child or so effective for one child, but it could be effective for one child who also has some skills. Mm-hmm. So it depends on the child, it depends on the level he is for the intensity of the hours, okay? Mm. Yeah.
So as long as it's intensive, like every day, then the parents need to continue at home. Like
yes, absolutely. Whatever. Because the moment you leave, some other behavior comes in. So that's why they've said 40 hours. The reason is he's always into this. So the child has rapid, repetitive programs, so he learns faster.
Yeah, but it doesn't really mean that you have to be in a center 40 hours a week.
Not necessary. If you can't do it, we have got children who come for 10 hours and still show very good results. So it's not, I'm not saying you have to do 40 hours, but then if you do 40 hours, of course you'll get better results. If you can't, then stick on to what you can do, but get as many people involved so you get, the child gets as many hours as possible.
So like if one child has like 40 hours a week, let's say like 3 years or 4 years old, like under five, then what do you think, what can you give idea, like what kind of program do they have? Like,
so they can have an intensive DTT program for 2 hours, they can have a natural environment program for 2 hours, they can bring ABA into their eating, their grooming, their other routines. Task analysis could be done for their, their task analysis their work. They could be still involved in kind of a structured program which could be covered there.
So it's not like DTT for the whole day, for 8 hours a day, DTT on the table.
Not necessarily. Normally we always try to put variety even in the play, social. So you have to cover all your domains. So maybe one therapist will cover play and social. Another therapist will cover a kind of DTT but with respect to language. Another therapist may cover DTT with respect to academics. So you can put in so much hours there. Yes, like schools.
Like school. So basically with kids who already would be ready at school, then go to school and then add additional hours for therapy.
So maybe 2 or 3 hours of additional therapy, that will help. Okay. Sometimes even there could be a LSA who's trained in ABA who could follow them in school and can do 2 hours of school wherever she can get a chance to do it.
Oke, okay. Jadi bapak-bapak ibu-ibu itu ya, jadi semua tidak hanya misalnya DTT, tapi meliputi semua kehidupan dari anak, mulai dari dia kemandirian, akademik, kalau yang membutuhkan akademik, kemudian tentu bahasa dititi dengan dititinya, bahasa sosial, bermain, dan segala macam programnya. Oke, okay. Thank you, Mira.
Thank you.
Bye.